Every second is a lifetime. And every minute more brings you closer to God. And you see nothing but the red lights. You let your body burn like never before. And it's...
Hallo zusammen, willkommen zu einer weiteren Folge Music Room auf mtv.ch. Unsere heutigen Gäste, die sind in 10 verschiedenen Ländern mit ihrem Debütalbum Happiness in der Top 10 drin gewesen. Und das hat ihnen auch diverse Gold- und Platin-Plaketten an die Wand hergespielt. Ich möchte sie herzlich willkommen heißen, der Theo und der Adam, besser bekannt als The Hurts. Hello guys.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, thanks. Good. Happy to be in Switzerland.
Oh, nice. Let us speak about your music. You both live in Manchester. Does the city have an influence on your music? I mean, there's a lot of great bands coming from that city after all.
It definitely does. I think when we were learning to make music, it was really important. There's lots of great bands, Oasis, Joy Division, New Order. It's a thriving place for musicians, and there was no better place to learn to make music than Manchester.
Regarding the claim that you're not making sad music, you're making hopeful music. Don't you think that hopeful music often is the saddest of all? Because ultimately, in the end, the listener knows that probably will end up in some distress or disaster anyway.
That's a really cool thing to say. It often is, I think. But for me, I feel the most happy when I listen to sadder music. I feel a lot more affirmed when I listen to sadder music. So.
More like a relief creating it,
yeah.
Then so
empathy, that's what it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, so they're also the title Happiness then for the album. Or?
Mm.
Hope is the overriding theme in our music, I think. I think it would have been easy to kind of make just purely depressing music and have no redemption, but yeah. We didn't want to be like that because it's not how we are as people, and I think that kind of hope is the most important thing on the album.
How important are the 80s for your music? I mean, is it only about that, or is it just the beginning of what is about to come?
I mean, there's some 80s bands that were very important, like Depeche Mode and Tears for Fears, and Prince was the kind of thing that at the beginning when we met each other, that was kind of the big influence, really. So there is parts of the 80s.
Mm, but we grew up we were only babies then, and we don't really have any sort of connection with it. So it was useful to pick and choose, but we grew up in the 90s, and it was people like Oasis and Blur and Pulp and people like that who shaped who we became as people, and so I think that's had a big effect on it as well. So, and just pop music in general, I think 90s was a great time for pop music. So
yeah, what was the greatest thing then about the 80s for you, or let's say the 90s then, what influenced you?
I think for both of us it's that pop music was celebrated, and it was something that had a lot of thought put into it. People like Prince, Michael Jackson, Madonna, and people who cared about it and didn't just make it throwaway or cheap, I think. And that's what's really inspiring for us, is to make it exciting for people and new. Yeah.
And you also said once in an interview that a pop star has the responsibility to write songs that people want to buy. So what do you think went wrong in the last few years? Because it doesn't seem like people really want to buy no music no more. It's more about free downloads and file sharing. And
It's difficult.
I think for me, as a music buyer, as a music fan, like, I felt a little bit let down that people didn't put enough care into it. And they made songs that came and disappeared and just to fit into a trend, yeah, that people would care about. And all my favourite bands have always done that, have made great pop music that has had a lot of thought put into it, and I don't know. I think it's something that will always exist in pop music.
I think we wanted to make a strong album, you know, a complete body of work, I suppose, because you know my favourite bands. I love the album tracks, and I love the kind of the effort that was put into making a complete album. And it's a very singles dominated world, I guess, music these days. So I think there's bands as well, like Mumford & Sons are a British band who made an incredible album, and I think the more focus on albums, the better for me, I think.
You also have a very, very big star on your album with Kylie Minogue. How did that happen? How did you get together?
We were sat one day and we'd finished all the album and we'd been given so many amazing opportunities to do stuff. And one thing we'd learned is that you got to be brave sometimes and just kind of ask for things. And we sent her a letter that said, "Dear Kylie, we're Hurts. Would you like to sing on our song?" Didn't expect anything back, but we thought, if you don't ask, you don't get. And then, like 2 weeks later, she got back and said she'd love to, which was amazing. And then the following week, we were sat in the studio singing with Kylie Minogue. And it's even to talk about it still, it's really bizarre because it seems like such a simple way to do it, but I guess if you don't ask.
I think it's a different part of her personality on our song, though. There's a period in the 90s where she did a song called Confide in Me, which we also cover, and a few others where there's a darker side to her character, and it's a side that we both really like, and the opportunity to get that side onto one of our songs was, I think it shows her in a great light.
Very nice. Just ask. That's a very nice ending.
We've just got to work out who to ask next now.
Yeah.
Or what to ask for next.
Just Kylie again.
We'll just get our Kylie on again, yeah.
We'd love to do a whole album with her, right?
Maybe one on every album.
Yeah.
Then after 10 years, release the best of and...
Yeah, why not? That would be a great idea. Looking forward to that one. Thanks for your time, guys.
No problem. Thank you very much.
Hope you have a great time also with your show tonight and enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Und das wär's gsi mit den Hurts. Da aus dem Palais Extra in Zürich. Klickt doch nächste Woche wieder rein auf mtv.ch und holt euch das neueste Update vom Music Room. Salut!